After last week's video, I got a lot of messages asking how someone can get into game design without a degree, or if I felt a degree was necessary at all to get a job in the industry. The short answer is no, you don't need a degree to get a job in the industry. So in today's video, I'm going to explain a little bit more about why I think this is the case. I am also going to give you some tips on things that you can do to get that job if you don't currently have a degree in game design. First of all, the game industry is different from other industries in the sense that a degree is not as relevant as hands-on experience for certain positions. What really counts is what you know how to do. Now, when it comes to game design, it's tricky, because this is not something easy to evaluate in candidates without seeing their work. Therefore, one of the most common requirements you will find is the number of shipped or published games you have. Let's use game programming as an example. You can probably tell if someone knows programming or not by asking a few questions related to math or coding, giving them a practical exam, etc. However, with game design, there has to be more time investment from people looking at portfolios, having discussions about why games are good or bad, understanding how the candidate thinks, etc. Because of this, having a game design degree is almost useless in the game industry from my perspective. The only reason why I got my master's at the time was because when I studied it, there weren't other ways of learning like there are today. I go into my story in my previous video, which I'll link here. But I will share that living in a third world country makes it a lot harder to get noticed if your goal is the AAA industry. So I decided to take the leap and further my education. But that doesn't mean this has to be the case for you as well. I know a lot of people with degrees in English, aerospace, business, neuroscience, among many others, who ended up as game designers and are pretty successful. Again, from an employer's perspective and talking from experience, when I hire game designers, having a solid portfolio is far more important than any fancy degree someone might have. These degrees are a nice plus, especially if it is from one of the top colleges. They do help validate the candidate's experience and formal training. Yet, nothing trumps an amazing portfolio with an awesome demo you can test. So what can you do to get some education in game design when a degree is not the right choice for you? Well, there are a few ways. And the good news for those who are in a tight financial situation is that some of them are completely free. If game design is something you really want to do, there is definitely a way to get there without spending a lot of money. Now keep in mind that if you don't have a degree, there is a chance you're going to need to work harder and you will need discipline to push and motivate yourself to do things. When you go to school, the advantage of that setting is that you are required to do projects and make games to pass the courses, which you can add to your portfolio very easily while doing your coursework. The first thing that I would recommend to someone trying to learn game design is to get one book that I really liked and that was basically my Bible for the 3 years I studied at USC. The book is called Game Design Workshop by Tracy Fullerton. This book will show you game design starting from the very basics. The coolest part is that not only does it include video games, but it also starts you with board games, which helps take the pressure of learning programming right away. Designing board games is a great way of getting started into game design, and those are way easier to playtest than video games. You can always use them as bonding time with your family and play your game together. You can also put these board games in your portfolio when you are done. In fact, I designed 2 board games while I was learning, and it's a great way of just learning design without the hassle of worrying about if the game is working properly or not. The second thing is to join as many game jams as you can. That way, you can learn how game development works as a team, as opposed to just working by yourself on a game. This is also a skill that will be helpful for you when you look for a job. Also, a big part of learning game design, as opposed to other subjects, is that it is learned almost by trial and error. Being able to work with people who have more experience than you or who have different strengths will help you push yourself to learn different things. Having the ability to work on a small game that you can later have other people play is amazing. You get to see how they react, what they like, what they don't like, and why. This is huge when you are first learning games. I remember the first time I playtested a game formally. It was super scary and exciting at the same time. Sure, it made me feel worthless the first couple of times I did it. People were brutal and stomping all over my game, but you eventually learn that this is part of the job. The tough criticism will help you become an even better game designer. The third thing that you can do is to enroll in an online course. There are a lot of online courses that teach game design and aren't too expensive. I have mentioned this before, but I really like Udemy as a learning platform. They almost always hold promotions on their courses, which makes them really affordable, and you can learn a ton from them. The tricky part with this approach is that you need to have the accountability to sit down every day for a few hours and actually use them. If you buy all these courses and you don't actually study or use them, you aren't going to learn. I actually invested in a couple of these courses, especially the ones that allow you to learn Unity. This has allowed me to have a better grasp of how the engine works, and now I feel way better when I need to use the engine to prototype a feature. Another great school, especially if you are more into 3D environmental level design, is CGMA. This school is a little more expensive, but certainly not as expensive as a full degree. I took the level design course here, and it was great. It was taught by Emilia Schatz, the lead level designer at Naughty Dog at the time. And the great thing about this is that you end up with a couple of prototypes showing your abilities with level design and combat design. You also get to see what your peers are doing and can learn from that as well. After learning some things about game design, how game development works, maybe have a couple of game jams under your belt before you try volunteering for a gaming company. I understand this might not be possible for some people, but for me, it was a great way to experience. I did this after I graduated, since I wasn't getting any luck in the job market. I volunteered for a company that was working on games to teach kids numbers and letters. Although it was unpaid and it wasn't what I wanted to do for a living, this experience helped me get my feet wet into what it was like to work for a company. It also helped me to fill the gap in my resume after graduation. It helped me keep practicing and it taught me other valuable skills like working in teams, getting feedback and working remotely, which is very valuable these days. Finally, my last piece of advice for you will be to always keep learning and network. Try to connect with people through LinkedIn and ask for advice. Don't just try to ask them for a job. Spend the time building genuine connections that allow for you to build a strong network that can eventually get you a job. I made a video where I discussed this a little further, which I will also link here. Getting a game design job with or without a degree is no easy task, but I think it is possible if you do the right things and connect with the right people. By focusing on having a strong portfolio, having a strong network and a good knowledge of the industry, I think anyone can land a job in the industry. Bear in mind that you also need to have patience, since in a lot of these jobs, there is unfortunately more demand than there is supply. A lot of people want to become game designers, but actually only a few have the skills needed for the job. As long as you follow these steps and keep getting better at your craft every single day, you should be able to land your next job in the industry, even if it takes a little longer than you expected. And that's it, you guys. Thank you so much for watching. If you have any other questions or concerns about this topic, please let me know in the comment section below. Also, if you like this video, please hit the like button and share it with your friends. See you next time!